Good morning, students. So we'll be starting a new chapter, chapter 5. The name of the chapter is States of Matter. The base of this chapter was in class 9 earlier. So we'll start with recalling the pre-knowledge about this chapter. So you had studied about three states of matter, isn't it? Solid, liquid, and gas. If you can remember, solid used to become liquid by heating. And this process was called as fusion or melting. The temperature at which it used to happen was called as melting point. Liquid used to become gas also on heating. Okay. And gas used to become liquid on cooling. This was called as evaporation. Conversion of liquid to gas was evaporation, and conversion of gas to liquid was called as condensation. Then, sometimes liquid was also frozen to form solid, like ice or water can be converted into ice. This was called as solidification. Or freezing. The word freezing is used in case we bring down temperature lower than room temperature. When we bring down the temperature lower than room temperature, we call it as freezing. Else, say for example, if molten metal is there and it becomes solid, then we call it as solidification, not freezing. If wax becomes solid, then we will be saying solidification, not freezing, because for that lower temperature is not required. Now there was one more mode of conversion of one state of matter to the other. That was solid becoming liquid directly, or solid becoming gas directly. This was called as sublimation. And also the reverse process was also called as sublimation. Okay, if gas directly becomes solid, then also it is called as sublimation. Like in case of iodine, naphthalene, camphor, you know, same case, iodine, naphthalene, camphor, this we have seen in our class 9. Now to this, you have to understand that in case of solid, the intermolecular forces are strong. As a result, the interparticular space is also less. Particles are closely packed in case of solids. But in case of liquids, interparticular force of attraction was comparatively less. Intermolecular force of attraction is comparatively less. And in case of gases, intermolecular force of attraction is negligible. They have large space between the particles. So all these things we have seen. Now we will discuss solids and liquids more in class 12. A little bit of discussion about liquid will be there. when we'll be discussing about surface tension and viscosity of liquid. Solids we will be discussing on a special chapter in class 12, that will be the first chapter, solid states. So this will not be discussed now. Our prime focus in this class 11th will be studying about gases and its nature. Okay, so this will be very important. So in states of matter, although it is a wholesome topic, but here we will be focusing more on the property and the nature of gases, and hence we will learn the property of the gases in terms of gas laws. Okay, so this part we have done now, we have just recalled. Now we will see a few gas laws. So with the help of these laws, the nature of the gas can be understood, or the converse is also true to say that by studying the nature of the gas, we can make laws. So let me write the first gas law. Let the first gas law which I am going to write is Avogadro's law. According to Avogadro's law, in short, we can write that volume is directly proportional to the number of particles of the gas. So how we can state it? We can state it like this. At constant temperature and pressure, okay, now this temperature, pressure and volume we will be writing as T, P and V, and it will be accepted in this chapter. At constant temperature and pressure, equal volume of gases occupy equal number of gaseous particles. Now when I say particles, it can be molecules or it could be atoms also. Example, in mole concept we have studied that at STP, that means standard temperature and pressure, the value of which would be 0 degree C standard temperature and 1 atm pressure, volume of 1 mole of any gas will be equivalent to 22.4 liter. So that means we can write that 22.4 liter of any gas at standard temperature and pressure is equal to 6.02 to 10 to the power 23 particles. These particles can be molecules or atoms of gas. So very clearly here we are seeing that volume is directly proportional to the number of particles for a given condition, for a given condition. Now even if the temperature is not standard and the pressure is not standard, if we fix the value of temperature and pressure to any value, it will have some kind of fixed relation with the number of gaseous molecule and the volume occupied, irrespective of the size of the gaseous molecule, shape of the gaseous molecule or any other factor. Okay, so this is a general rule given, and there are discrepancies in this rule, but to large extent it can be applied. Now we will be studying about certain theories related with the kinetic molecular theory, like when the gaseous molecules move in a vessel, how they behave. Okay, now certain assumptions which are made and they are written down in kinetic molecular theory of gases, there are certain discrepancies due to which I am saying that this theory has little discrepancy, but still to large extent it can be applied. Okay, because these all assumptions are based on real gas, ideal gas condition means the space between the gaseous molecules should be very high, the temperature should be higher, the pressure should be low. But at a high pressure, low temperature and a very less distance between the gaseous molecule, like when they are in the form of a fume or condensate, at that time these laws, they deviate and corrections are required to be done at that case. Okay, so that we will be seeing in special cases. As of now, broadly this much is required. So one was Avogadro's law, next we will see Charles' law. According to Charles' law, volume increases with increasing temperature. But by how much? It increases like this, that volume of a of any gas increases by 1 by 273.15 times of initial volume for every 1 degree C rise in the temperature. Now if you convert this into a mathematical equation, how will it be like? Say when temperature, is equal to 0 degree C, then let volume be equal to V0. Now when temperature is equal to some value T degree C, then let its volume, be equal to Vt. So we can write Vt is equal to V0 plus T times into 1 by 273.15 of V0. So we can write Vt is equal to V0 will become common, 1 plus T by 273.15. So if this is the temperature, if this is a value which gives us about, gives us the idea of temperature, and if this gives us the idea of volume, so we can say that volume is proportional to temperature. So we can say that for condition 1, V1 will be equal to some constant K T1, and V2 for condition 2 will be, the constant will remain constant, will become T2. So constant will remain same, K will be V1 by T1, and here also K will be V2 by T2. So according to Charles' law, we can write V1 by T1 equal to V2 by T2. This is the simplest expression which we will be using very often. Okay, simplest expression. And this was the detailed explanation. So if you remember this much, it will help you a lot. Okay, next is Boyle's law. We will see Boyle's law. at constant temperature. Pressure on a gas is inversely proportional to volume. So P is equal to, or P is proportional to 1 by V. So we can write P is equal to some constant K by 1 by V. For condition 1, P1 will be equal to 1 by V1 multiplied by K, and for condition 2, for other values of temperature, for some other value of temperature, P2 will be equal to the constant K 1 by V2. So in this case we can write K is equal to P1 V1, and in this case we can write K is equal to P2 V2. So the expression which comes out would be P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. This was Boyle's law. Now if you combine all the three laws, then what we will get? So we will get combined gas law. Combined gas law. First was V1 by T1 equal to V2 by T2. This was Charles' law. Or we can say from Charles' law. Then again, P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. This was from Boyle's law. And also V1 by N1 is equal to V2 by N2, or we can say V1, or let it be like that. This comes from Avogadro's law. So if you combine all these, so we will be getting what we will get? We will get P1 V1 by T1. And with V1, N1 will go over here. So for 1 mole of gas, it will be same only. Say if N1 is equal to N2 is equal to 1 mole. So it becomes easy now. We can write P2 V2 by T2. This is called as combined gas law. Now third equation is, next equation is ideal gas equation. Pressure is directly proportional to number of molecules of the gas. Pressure is directly proportional to temperature on the gas. So pressure is proportional to N and T both. So let R be the constant. So P also, volume is proportional to N and T. So we can write P into V is proportional to N into T. So if we make it equation, it will become PV is equal to N some constant R into T. It is called as universal gas constant. it has a value. The value is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. When we will be solving numericals based on this equation, then these values will get remembered. So this is called as combined, this is called as ideal gas equation, or it is also called as equation of state. So two things we have discussed today. We have discussed about gas laws, we have discussed about the pre-knowledge required, we have discussed about ideal gas equation. But to discuss anything above that, we need to solve a few problems based on this formula, and then we will come to kinetic molecular theory of gases. Alright, so this much will be enough for this much duration. More than this will become too much of the content to be studied. Alright, so in the next video, what we will be doing is, we will be solving numerical problems based on these formulas, so that these formulas and the concept becomes more and more clear. And then we will be going ahead with kinetic molecular theory of gases, the drawbacks of kinetic theory of gases, then what modifications we do to convert the ideal gas assumptions into real behavior of the gas, that is related with the volume correction and pressure correction by Van der Waal. And then we will study a little bit about the liquid state, their surface tension and viscosity. Okay, that is it for today. Thank you.